Wow. So in other words, you're talking about is having this inward and horizontal and vertical relationships. Inwardly, you use this word calling, and which sometimes for a lot of people, it is a heavy or big word. Because even when I mention the word calling, sometimes people may think that it's something that I have to endure. You know, it's not really my shapes or my strengths. But you talk about figuring out why on earth, oh, what is the point that I'm actually living on this planet Earth? And that is to, of course, to utilize once again the skill, the resources that God has given to all of us, not as a self-centered kind of ambitions, but to serve others. You also use the word ministry, which may not be necessarily be common, you know, in the, I guess, the modern world, but yet it is a platform for us to continue to serve others. So it's something that's bigger than us, beyond than us.
Yeah, that's right. Exactly right.
Wow. Wonderful. All right. We also understand that, Paul, you are one of the founding fathers of existential positive psychology. So in a nutshell, what is existential positive psychology and how does it differ from positive psychology?
Okay. So most people do not understand the difference. Okay. Mm. It is very different. It asks a very different set of questions. For example, as an existential positive psychologist, I will ask the question, how can one be happy while living in pain?
Okay.
So the positive psychology is talk about having happiness. But now I'm asking the question, how can I find happiness when I'm suffering in pain, in poverty? How? Mm. Another way to ask is that, instead of asking what's right, what's good and right about us, so we ask, what is right and good of us in a world full of suffering and evil, in a situation when we ourselves have the capacity for evil, when we often inflict pain to ourselves. So how can we be right and good while fighting this civil war within us?
The flesh
fight against the spirit. The flesh do things the spirit doesn't want to do. So we, like Apostle Paul, we all go through this inner struggle. So you cannot just ask what's right and good about without recognizing that we have to deal with our inner demons, we'll deal with our capacity for evil, we'll deal with a world full of suffering.
Yeah.
It's in that context, how can we be good and right? So there's a very different question. It's a much higher bar. It's meeting people where they are.
Yeah.
It's asking people to face the reality that we are not living in Disneyland. We're living in the real world.
Yeah.
There were all kinds of troubles. Just turn on TV. All you hear is crime, war, you know, all kinds of troubles. We can't pretend it doesn't. We gotta pretend all the problems don't happen. Even marriages. And all my clients, no matter how successful they are, they all have problems in their marriages, in their career. Yeah. So example psychologists say, given the reality of suffering, how can we find meaning and happiness? How can we be our best self, our real best self, not a dream, you know, the illusionary best self?
Yeah.
How can we be our best self, incorporating our dark shadow, our failure, our brokenness, our need for redemption, for healing? Rebirth. So it is existential psychology asks much tougher questions.
Yeah.
And meet people where they are, not you know, in an ideal situation of when life is neutral or love is passive.
Yeah.
You meet people where they are. So you try to help people, even in the deepest hell, we'll say, no, your deepest hell might be a pathway to heaven. Often, our hell bring us awareness of our need for God. In my desperation, I get to know God. Many people in their desperation, they no other source of help. They cry out to God.
Yes.
For example, William James, he suffered from depression and anxiety. He talked about this sick soul. The soul is sick. He finally, in his desperation, he said, I believe as if God exists. I believe there's meaning in life. The power of belief enabled him to experience rebirth. Enabled him to overcome his sickness, his mental health problem.
Yeah.
So all of us can benefit from God's help. So that is something that I desperately want people to hear that. God is very near and God is our help.
Yeah.
We have to humble ourselves and by leap of faith, reach out to God for help. God can meet us where we are. And so that's why as a Existential Psychology is a very spiritual way of looking at things. And also a very optimistic way of looking at things. We realize how hard life is and how much people suffer. And yet we say, fear not.